to generate energy. So energy is also a very, very important thing. And I told last time to my students that if they should really earn money, they should go into energy research. They say, find an energy block which is that tiny and delivers an amount of energy. And then one student said, yeah, we have it. And I said, whoa, really? Wow, I was fascinated. Yeah, nuclear power. But of course, we know that this might be dangerous. You utilize energy and most of all to process information. So this is the evolution here from this cell point cloud data to this animal and finally to this person, Schrödinger in this example. And this is from the original paper from 1944. What is life? The physical aspect of the living cell. One of the most famous papers of Schrödinger. Okay, how do people interact? I have shown you now some examples from the life sciences. But if you're not interested in the life sciences, then you can say, oh, he's waffling about the biomedical domain and blah, 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 and so on. Can you show me some other examples? The fascinating thing is that these approaches are generic. That means that we can switch the domain and apply it to different things. For example, how do people interact or how do they find their leaders? How do groups get together to solve a problem? Problem solving using, for example, intelligence, swarm intelligence or collective intelligence. This is a nice